Lots of people ask me, am I a modern day, real life Dr. Frankenstein? And I guess I am. I'm producing a potential monster. Or a god, depending on how you look at it. I'm a brain builder. I build artificial brains. And I believe this development in time will have more impact on humanity in the 21st century than the development of the hydrogen bomb. In 1992, I had the idea of using a new kind of microchip that could be programmed. And I wondered what would happen if these chips could be programmed to wire themselves up in a random way. Most wouldn't work, but some would be far more efficient than is humanly designable. I would then have the building blocks to create an artificial brain. I really think this discovery was inevitable. I just happened to get there first. A lot of people feel that there's something inherent in humanness that's just absolutely impossible to reproduce in a machine. I personally do not believe that. All the genius of Michelangelo and Beethoven and Einstein, to me, it's just a slightly more extraordinary interaction of molecules than the kind that we see in ordinary people. Einstein was religious in the sense that for him, the laws of physics, they were his god. And in a sense, I suppose I'm the same. If you read a lot of science, then your view of the world is that the world is essentially mechanistic, where constructions of electromagnetic fields and atoms and molecules and so forth, subject to blind Darwinian forces, and you end up with creatures like us. I'm not impressed by humanity's achievements in comparison to what's coming. Sooner or later, you can imagine billion-dollar budget type national brain building projects getting off the ground, equivalent to, say, NASA. Now, in the short to middle term, say, next 30, 40 years, probably brain building will be a wonderful benefit to humanity because it won't be threatening, because it won't be smart enough, but it will be smart enough to be very useful, like household cleaner robots, friendship robots, sex robots, whatever. And these things just keep getting smarter and smarter every year until everybody's saying, well, where's this going to stop? The problem is longer term. Computers will just become more and more powerful. They'll take control of our daily lives to an increasing extent until something bad happens. You don't understand how these circuits function. They're too complex. There's too many of them. They just do their own thing. As human beings, we can kill them off if we don't like what they're doing. We just exterminate them. But what happens if they really start getting smart? Then they may become conscious that we are a threat. We have the ability to kill them. So possibly they may start learning to defend themselves. I feel very schizophrenic about the work that I do, because with my left hand I build these things and with my right hand I raise the alarm. You're talking about taking the risk that literally billions of people are just wiped off the face of the earth. This is diabolical, what I'm saying. It's totally logical and cold and rational, but mad. It's just insane. It's an issue that will not go away. In fact, it will just get worse and worse and worse as time goes on. You'll have tremendous momentum. It will be a very hard process to stop. We're still a long way off from producing a true human brain-like artificial brain. But to me, the writing's on the wall. The progress is there. It's only a question of time. For me, it's not a question of if, it's a question of when artificial intelligence levels reach the human level. And then the big question of do we allow these artifacts to go beyond human level? We now have a major job ahead of us trying to persuade humanity that this issue is real. It's coming. And it will not go away if you make an analogy with the early discussion of the nuclear physicists in the 30s. They knew that it would be possible to make a single bomb powerful enough to destroy a whole city. They got the numbers. They knew this was coming. But virtually nobody took them seriously, because if you're living in the 30s, the biggest bomb around then would blow up a big building or something. That was it. So they just weren't listened to. But they knew they were right, so they persisted. And in fact, it was only 12 years between the time of the first idea that you could get a nuclear chain reaction to Hiroshima. So it moved rather quickly. I identify strongly with one of the founders of this whole nuclear era called Leo Szilard. He was a Hungarian-American nuclear physicist. He was the guy who first had the idea that you could actually split an atom and release enormous quantities of energy. And he had a sense of doom. He became more and more conscious of the possibility of a holocaust, a nuclear holocaust, where billions would die. So he was just terrified of his own invention. He could see the implications. And I and a growing number of other brain builders are very, very frightened. The implications are so profound, so enormous, that I'll be thinking about it in a rational kind of way before I go to sleep. And then I'll wake up shuddering. I end up sobbing because, Jesus Christ, what am I doing? How many people are going to die out of this potentially? And that's scary as hell. What is more important than the survival of the human species to human beings? It's fundamental. And on the other hand, you have the potential of creating creatures that would be godlike. It's absolutely magnificent. These two ideologies, these two philosophies, are irreconcilable. You have all the options for a major war. The technologies are there to create just enormous damage, what I call gigadeath. But the horrible thing is, billions, that's the population of the Earth. I truly hope that by raising the alarm now, humanity will have time to protect itself. I won't see it. I'll be dead in 30 years, and that's not enough time for this whole scenario to unfold. But my grandchildren will see it. They will suffer from it. They will be destroyed by it, potentially.